boundary funding is the topic. So boundary funding is nothing but replacement decisions in the case of capital budgeting. So in the boundary funding, why the company wants to go for replacement decision with respect to bonds is, if the interest rates in the market are falling and the company can incur lower interest rate cost for the same value of bonds, so that company can go for, if this is the case, then the company is going to choose replacement decisions for the bonds. So accordingly, what company has to do for considering the bond refunding decision is, it has to calculate incremental NPV. So for calculating incremental NPV, what we have to calculate, we have to find out what are the incremental cash outflows and what are the incremental cash inflows, and we can find out incremental NPV. Okay, so the question here is, ABC Limited is having 300 million rupees at 12% interest rate, which are outstanding for 6 years remaining to the maturity. Okay, so these are existing ones which carry 12% interest rates. Okay, the question is saying that interest rates are falling, so ABC is thinking of refunding these bonds with 300 million, which are also having a 6 years bond and also having a coupon rate of 10%. See, the existing bonds of company is having 12% interest rates, but the new bonds are carrying 10% interest rates. So that's the, there is a savings of 2% for the same 300 million amount, and life of the bond is also 6 years. Here is also, there are 6 years remaining for the existing bond. So that's why, as there is a chance of 2% interest rate savings, the company wants to go for bond refunding. Okay, so for issuing the new bonds, there is an issue cost of 6 million rupees. Okay, and the company has to pay call premium of 4%. Okay, these are the cash outflows. Okay, next, there is a 9 million being the unamortized portion of issue cost of old bonds, can be written off no sooner the old bonds are called off. So as soon as the existing bonds are redeemed, the issue cost relating to the old bonds is 9 million, which are unamortized portion. Means whatever the issue cost is there for the issuing the bonds, it has to be amortized over the period of the bond life. So as the bond is having 6 years remaining life of, for the existing 300 million 12% bonds, the unamortized portion is with respect to issue cost is 9 million. So the company has to write off these 9 million over 6 years. But as the company is redeeming this 300 million today, it has to write off this 9 million today only. Okay, the company is having a marginal tax rate of 30%. So now it is asking us to analyze the bond refunding decision. Okay, let's go to the solution. So first of all, what we have to consider here is, we have to calculate net outflow in year 0. Okay, why we are calling net outflow means, there will be some tax savings. Those tax savings will be considered as inflows. So in the year 0, there will be outflows, inflows in the form of tax savings. That's why net outflow will be there in year 0. So let's go. Now in year 0, the company has to pay 6 million in the form of issue cost for issuing new bonds. Okay, so that will be outflow, and issue cost will be amortized over the period of life of the bond. So the company new bonds life is 6 years, so it will be amortized during the 6 years period only. So it will, there will be no tax savings with respect to this issue cost. Hence there will be no inflow in year 0. There will be inflows in the form of tax savings with respect to this issue cost in year 1 to year 6 onwards. Okay, year 1 onwards to year 6. Okay, so there will be cash outflow of 6 million in the form of issue cost in year 0. And as the company is issuing the current bonds, I mean new bonds, which are carrying 10% interest rate at premium, it has to pay 12 million outflow in the form of premium. Okay, but this premium can be charged to the profit and loss account in the year 0 itself. So there will be tax savings of 30% with respect to this premium. The premium percentage is 4% and the value of the bonds is 300. Accordingly, 12 million will be the premium. So with respect to this 12 million, there will be tax savings of 30%. So accordingly, it is getting 3.6 million tax savings for the call premium charging to the profit and loss account. So the net cash outflow will be 8.4 million. So this is with respect to call premium. Okay, so in the question, it is given that 9 million is the unamortized portion of issue cost with respect to old bonds. So as the company is redeeming the old bonds, it has to write off this unamortized portion of issue cost of old bonds in the year zero itself. So it has to charge 9 million to the profit and loss account. So as expenditure is increasing with respect to an amount of to the extent of 9 million, there will be tax savings at the rate of 30% with respect to the extent of 9 million. That will be, if you calculate a tax millions on 9 million, will be 2.7. So those tax savings are considered as inflow. So there is no outflow with respect to tax savings of unamortized portion of issue cost, because this 9 million has already incurred with respect to issue of old bonds. So so now the company is amortizing. So as the old bonds are redeemed today, the company has to write off this issue cost today. So the expenditure is increasing 9 million and accordingly there will be a saving of 2.7 million. So 2.7 million will be the outflow in the year zero. So these are all the outflows and inflows in year zero. So first part is calculating net outflow in year zero. So if you consider issue cost, there will be only 6 million outflow. For call premium, there is 8.4 million net cash outflow. Okay, and in the form of tax savings with respect to writing off unamortized portion of issue cost of old bonds, there will be an inflow of 2.7 million. So finally, net outflow in year zero is 11.7 million. So let's say this value is equals to A. Okay, now we have to calculate annual cash inflows which are happening to the company during 6 years life of the new bond. Okay, this will be happening on per annum basis. So see, the company has to pay interest in the case of old bonds is 36 million, means 300 million is the bonds value, and it has to pay 12% interest in the case of old bonds. That will be 36 million is old interest rate, old interest amount. But in the case of new interest, that is 300 into 10% will be the new interest rate. So 30 will be new interest outflow. So in old bonds, the company is having 36 million outflow, but in new bonds, the company is having only 30 million outflow. So there is a savings of 6 million. Okay, these savings will be considered as inflow, as there is a savings in cost. So as whenever there is a savings in cost, it will be considered as inflow. Okay, so this inflow is with respect to interest. So it is considered as income. Is so the profit and loss account is not debited with the 6 million. Hence, there will be a loss of 1.8 million with respect to this inflow of 6 million in the form of tax. So see, here there is a saving of 6 million. This will be an imaginary inflow. I mean, previously the profit and loss account is debited with 36 million, but now it is only debited with 30 million. Means here the income is not reducing to the extent of 6 million. So that's how there is an inflow. So accordingly, there is a 30% tax rate on the extra 6 million savings, and that will be 1.8 million. This is considered as outflow. So now the net inflow is 6 million minus 1.8. It will be 4.2 million in the form of savings in interest cost. The company go for replacement decision. Okay, now go to the second one, that is loss in tax savings on amortized portion of issue cost. So in the case of old bonds, it is having an amortized portion of issue cost with to the extent of 9 million, and it has to be amortized over 6 years life to the maturity in the case of old bonds. In that case, it is charging the profit and loss account with 1.5 million, 9 divided by 6 years equals to per annum 1.5 million. It is costing. So in that case, if we calculate tax savings with respect to that 1.5 million, it is having 0.45 million of tax savings in the case of old bonds. Whereas in the case of new bonds, tax savings with respect to issue cost is 6 million. It has incurred issue cost, and it has to be amortized over 6 years. And in that case, if we calculate tax savings with respect to that issue cost per annum basis, amounts to 0.3 million. See, if you compare these two issue costs, tax savings with respect to issue cost, there is a loss of 0.15 million. So that will be outflow as it is loss to the company. That should be considered as an outflow on per annum basis. As this issue cost has to be amortized over 6 years, it has to be considered on 0.15 million is happening, is a loss happening to the company during the 6 years period on annual basis, right? So that will be the outflow. So now these are only the outflows and inflows happening on annual basis. So if you see, the company is having savings in interest cost on net basis is 4.2 million. This is an inflow. Savings, no? Interest cost is an outflow, but we are considering savings. So that will be inflow 4.2 million. And now in the form of loss in tax savings on amortized portion of issue cost, it is having 0.15 million. So totally net inflow on per annum basis, the company is receiving 4.05 million every year for a period of 6 years. So now we are having all the inputs which are required to calculate NPV. But there is a small thing that to know to calculate NPV is, see, the current market rate is 10%, but it is pre-tax. If you calculate a post-tax rate of interest, that will be 7%. So this 7% should be used to the for the purpose of discounting. So okay, now year zero the company is having outflow of 11.7 millions, and that will be 11.7 millions. The factor is 1, and present value cash flow cash flows occurring to the company will be 11.7. So the we have already calculated per annum basis cash inflow is 4.05 million. So 1 to 6 years it, on annual basis the company is receiving 4.05 millions, and annuity factor for at the rate of 7% for 6 years is 4.766. So that will be 19.30 million inflow. So now the company is having outflow and inflow. These are all incrementals. Okay, what we have calculated here is these are all our incremental cash outflows and incremental cash inflows. So automatically the incremental NPV amounts to 7.6 million. So as the incremental NPV is positive, going for bond refunding means replacing the existing bonds of 12% interest rate with new bonds of 10% interest is beneficial to the company. So that is the final decision. So as NPV is positive, replacement of old bonds with new bonds is beneficial. Okay, this is all about bond refunding topic. See, the current market rate is 10%, but it is pre-tax. If you calculate a post-tax rate of interest, that will be 7%. So this 7% should be used to the for the purpose of discounting. So okay, now year zero the company is having outflow of 11.7 millions, and that will be 11.7 millions. The factor is 1, and present value cash flow cash flows occurring to the company will be 11.7. So the we have already calculated per annum basis cash inflow is 4.05 million. So 1 to 6 years it, on annual basis the company is receiving 4.05 millions, and annuity factor for at the rate of 7% for 6 years is 4.766. So that will be 19.30 million inflow. So now the company is having outflow and inflow. These are all incrementals. Okay, what we have calculated here is these are all our incremental cash outflows and incremental cash inflows. So automatically the incremental NPV amounts to 7.6 million. So as the incremental NPV is positive, going for bond refunding means replacing the existing bonds of 12% interest rate with new bonds of 10% interest is beneficial to the company. So that is the final decision. So as NPV is positive, replacement of old bonds with new bonds is beneficial. Okay, this is all about bond refunding topic.